J-Shrek, I tell you what, man, I am so pumped up today. And why would I be so pumped up? We're in Gila, Bend, which is one of the most incredible places. If you are a fan of the ancients and a fan of petroglyphs and ruins, man, they have got it all. They've got intaglios. Wow, I'm hearing something. I think we got a chopper coming through here, but I'm on an estimated path and a trail, and we'll see if I am able to get to it. And we'll take this journey. I'm glad you guys could come along today. And here's a little bit about what we're going through. The hiking's not bad. Got a lava field we're going through right here. There's a few creeks that we'll cross through here, but not a lot. So we're going to take this journey through here and see if we can't come up. You know, usually a lot of times, man, it's a pretty difficult, you'll find in these locations. You just got to, you got to be patient. You got to do your best homework that you possibly can. And then you just got to, sometimes you just got to get lucky, you know. Got a good breeze going through here today. It's a little brisk. But I am really excited about this because one of the most incredible things that I have found since I've been doing this was the rock man. And to realize that there's more than one rock man, I am pretty stoked about that. What an incredible day today. You know, this is just an incredible journey today. You know, it shouldn't take very long to get to a location or an area that we think that this possibly could be in. So I've got an idea of what I want to do and where I want to go. We'll just have to get to it. You know, there's something about being out here that's really an incredible experience. Should be an incredible trip today to be able to find this missing link that we've been looking at. And to realize that, you know, people have been traveling through here for 8,000 years. Look at this. And really nice soft soil. It's really pretty neat to get to go through here. But I think we're on the right path. We'll just have to see. And I'm glad you guys could come along today. And it's really a pretty incredible story of these groups that used to interact. As we go through here, this is kind of what we're looking at, if you can kind of see. So we're kind of in the river bed or the river bottoms. I feel like I'm in my specified area. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start scanning around, looking through here and seeing what locations it could possibly be on and what ridges it could possibly be on. And we'll just have to work our way through here. Now we're gonna have to scan this whole area. We're not just gonna stumble on this. You know, one of the things about when you're doing Google Earth is that a lot of times looks a hell of a lot different than when you get out here. So you get used to realizing that, you know, what you see or what you think you see is gonna might be completely different when you get out there. You know, I'm going in a coordinates that I believe, and the coordinates is in my head, right? We got a general direction, then we're gonna go that way. You just don't know. I mean, a lot of times, even when you have a thought that, hey, it's gotta be in this vicinity, you know, you're not always right. I could have already walked by it and not seen it, because I really don't know what the ground structure is going to look like. And then it amazes me too is, you know, what was the purpose of this? I mean, they had definitely a purpose when they built this, whether it be spiritual or, you know, maybe it told them what time of the year it was. Maybe it lined up with the sun or the moon or a combination of both. And, you know, you wonder what that purpose was. When I'm walking out here too, I think, you know, they were walking along the same surface that I'm walking along right here too. And how incredible would that have been, you know, to be out here and walking in the same footpaths on a place that looks probably identical as it did 1,000 years ago. You know, the vegetation, the weather. You know, I'm looking for trails too, because trails would have led us to this place. And so here we finally got what I consider to be a trail. And I haven't seen a lot of trails out here. mean, I want to think I'm in something that reminds me of an area they might have been in, but I'm not seeing it yet. Well, we're just gonna have to circle around and see if we can't find it. I mean, we know we're in the area somewhere. I believe I am. You know, again, you just don't know that, but what a great day to be out here. Pretty much have the desert to yourself. I'll tell you, that structure there kind of looks like stacked rocks right there, but it's hard to say. A couple places that I would think maybe it would be, but I'm not sure. You know, I think we're in this broad, if you look across here. Now here's a nice trail right here, if you can see it. But I definitely think that I would be on it by now. I have not seen anything that has looked like an intaglio or just a rock structure or anything that has any bearing to any type of design, but I'm to the point of knowing that I've got to be at the edge of this. So now what we'll do is we'll work our way, and we definitely look like I'm on a trail right here. But boy, the sun's so bright, you can't hardly see another rock stacked on a rock. That definitely is not natural. Somebody stacked that right there, that's for sure. Look how wide open that is. Now the river would have flowed this side right here. So it would have come this side, and then it looks like it bends over to that point over there. So now the first thing we're gonna do is start to look and see if we see any type of petroglyphs on any of these rocks, any of these structures. Well, listen to how quiet this is. Now you want to be out in it, away from everything. This is about as good as it gets. So what I believe is it's either on that point, it's along this ridge line. We'll see if we can't find it. I'll tell you what, man, this is where it gets interesting when you're searching this stuff down and you know it's here. We're gonna scour. So we've been through that area over there, right? We've been all the way through there. And so we're gonna go along here. We've already scoured this back edge. Now we're gonna go one more time through here. And then, I don't know where the hell we're gonna go. We ain't leaving till we find it. Okay, that's our motto. Well, there's a ridge that we're on. So we came down here originally this way. So now we're gonna work our way east, and we're gonna head east. And if anybody knows about heading east, you probably know about St. Louis, Missouri, and you probably know the band Head East. So we're gonna do like the band does. We're gonna head east. Oh, here's a good trail right here. Let's just follow this trail right here. See it? See how distinctive that is? Kind of lose it a little bit through here, but let's take the ancient trail. We'll just keep trekking. That's what this is about, man. At least we're not in 120 degree weather thinking that we're gonna roast if we don't get to our location. Man, we have walked quite a ways, because there's that ridge that we were on right there. So we've walked about the same distance east and west that we have north and south. So we're gonna keep walking this way. And man, hopefully get you guys some surprise here. You know, but it's like Rockman. Rockman took me a year to find, so I'm not expecting any quick miracles. Work our way back over here. Now right there, okay, those rocks there, look at how they're waved. They don't look, that's not just natural, right? That these might be, but that is not. Okay, see, that's not a natural structure, either of these. So we've stumbled into something right here. Look at how they're squared out. They're not, I mean, I'm not positive just yet, but look at that. How, now here's a trail that runs through the middle, right? Now I'm seeing a structure there. Those are not natural. those are not natural structures, but you would have stumbled through here. You could have walked right through here and not even seen this unless you were really looking. So look at that. These are circles right through here. Those are man-made right there. That's not even a question. Look at that. Look at how it works through there. Look at this right through here. So we come down through here. Look at this. So we're in the middle of something right here. This is the one that we're looking for. We definitely have stumbled into a man-made structure right here. Now the trail runs right through the center of it. And then you can see another trail running off through here. But you know, look how you could have just stumbled through here and not even seen this. People could have walked through here, you know, a zillion miles. Okay, just getting on the end of the structure right there. As we walk down here, we definitely ran through the middle of a piece of some type of man-made structure. I can't tell you this is the one that we're looking at, but I can tell you that this is definitely man-made. But see, you could have stumbled through here and never seen this. You know, we definitely are in a spot. Now, I don't know if it's the spot, and I don't know if it's the exact location, but I can tell you one thing, that this is not natural, okay? These rocks didn't form these circles by themselves. So one thing we know is we're in an area. I don't know if it's the right area, but these are all structures, which, you know, gives you hope at least. I mean, you know, and the funny thing is, look at the crossroads in the trail, okay? Because we're standing at the crossroads of this trail here. You see the rocks stacked in this circle area right here. You see this? Man, now we got to find the twins. And we'll see. Okay, so here, look at that structure right there. Those are definite structures with this path that walks right through. So we need to make sure we're careful not to touch any of these rocks. Don't touch any of these rocks that were placed here. We don't want to break any of the mojo that was here originally. Wow, I tell you what, I'm stoked. Now I see another one over there. Look right over there. Look at that. Look at that structure over there. That is incredible. And here, look at that. Okay, wow, look at that. That is unbelievable. Now we're really seeing some very good structures right here. Look at this. I'm not going to tell you what I think that looks like. Man, you know, I'm getting a weird vibe that this was some type of fertile area, you know, something fertility. I'm really getting this fit theory and this thought process that this is some type of fertility area. I know that might sound weird to some of you, but I mean, it's bizarre. It really is. And even when I looked at this the first time I looked at it, and I'm not going to tell you what I thought it looked like, but it looked like male genitalia. It did. That's what it looked like to me. And so what else would make me believe that? Well, if I can see the twins, then maybe that will actually lead me in. I'm trying to think where, okay, so here looks like to be the end of the structure through here, which would put the twins, man, they gotta be here. You know, I've walked this whole ledge one time or another and I don't know where they would be. Oh, my God. I tell you what, I never stop getting excited about this area. I mean, and things when I'm looking for them and I find them, I'm like, holy cow, look at that. And now I've got to change my whole con. Look at this. I walk by these things twice. Here they are. Here are the twins. This is absolutely unbelievable. Look at that. Look how incredible that is. That is absolutely unbelievable. Look at that. Now, there is one twin, and look right there. That's huge. And look at that. And look at that. Well, so what's that tell me? That they're not twins at all. That's the woman and that's the man. That's just what my thought said, right? Because one has a humongous dingledoffer and the other does not. And so there is my thought process that maybe this is some type of fertility area. Wow. And they're not twins at all, it's a couple. I mean, I guess I could continue to call them the twins, but the truth of the matter is I think this is some area that is some type of fertility location. Wow, look at that. I'll try to get this up where you guys can see it. Look at that. That is so incredible. Man, I never thought that I'd find two of these. And now I wonder if the original Rock Man was a location just like I thought. But here is this other structure down on the end that definitely looks, well, wow. It's so incredible to me, regardless of what this location was, is to think that, you know, 1,000 years ago they were here. You know, this would have been a cool place to live right through here. And I tell you what, just like I told you, these rocks are unbelievable as far as the reflection. So we're going to go down through here and go to the edge now that we found that. So it's placed up into there. Man, you could have walked through here 1,000 times and not seen that. I walked by the twins. I'm going to keep calling them the twins, even though I think that was a different, I have to have a different philosophy, but I'm still going to call them the twins. Because it could have been twins, could have been male and female, could have been twins. So I'm going to keep with that. I kind of like the twins. And let's go down this ridge right here and see if we see anything that might. Because now that we found an area that they would have frequented and been at, so we know now that we have people in this vicinity. Now that was a tough one to find. I'm going to tell you now, there's a circle right there. Isn't that cool? So there is a circle right here, whether it be a sleeping circle or not. That's definitely a circle that was built. Okay, so we're seeing structures through here. So we're definitely in an area that they would have been hanging out at. And so we're going to go on down here and see if there's anything else that we might run into. That's a perfect circle right down there. Look at that. Look at that circle right here. That is definitely a circle right here. There's no doubt. This whole area was used, it looks like. Look at that. Can you imagine the fact that now whether they would have had a wiki up here or some type like that, sleeping circle, you know, you can tell how they worked around us. Look at that. Isn't that incredible to know that they placed those stones there 800, maybe 1,000 years ago? Isn't that incredible? You know, this would have been really easy entry into the riverbed. And that's not that many places in Gila that I've been on that have this kind of easy transition. Now, so could that have been some of the reason that they chose this location, because of easy access to the river? I mean, most of the place on Gila, kind of a pain to get in. And this was just a really easy in and out. So I'm going to go on this ridge and see if I can't find some petroglyphs. Considering it was so easy to get into, it wasn't even work. And again, that's odd here. Everything on the Gila is usually work of some type. You've got to really... But we're going to go back into this little canyon in here and see if there's anything back in here and see if we see any petroglyphs at all. You know, the only thing I can think is maybe there's something over there. That rock down there is very interesting. Well, because it's you guys here with me, I'm going to walk that ridge just a little bit. Not a hell, I'm not going to go crazy. But I am going to go down an old shit rock. I haven't been on an old shit rock since I've been here. My first old shit rock. So let's go in here and see if there's anything. And this does not look like the kind of rock that they would have used. A couple of old shit rocks. Okay, there's the first petroglyph. So we saw a petroglyph. We're going to say we saw a petroglyph. So there's definitely a petroglyph on this point. But, how crazy is that? So what kind of petroglyph is this? That is definitely an extremely unique petroglyph. Look at that. I've seen a lot of petroglyphs. I can tell you, I've never seen anything like that. Now, if I wouldn't have made this run down here, you know, I would have missed that. That's pretty incredible. You know, I don't know what the hell that signified, and it's kind of bizarre that it's here. I'm telling you, these rocks are brutal though. So if you got one petroglyph. Now here's the funny thing about that. If they only put one petroglyph, how special was that petroglyph? It would have had to have been extremely special. You know, the Gila Bend is just an incredible place, and you can't help but look out there and think how, you know, that river changed people's lives. The people that live and died here, whether it be, you know, 1,000, 8,000, 200, you know, how people, you know, the water was life and how critical that is, not only to everywhere in the country, but especially in the desert, where, you know, without it, you're going to die, and you're going to die fast. So these communities grew up along this river, and it's incredible because I still can see a group of cavalry, or maybe a hunting group, or, you know, trappers. You know, this is a major trapper area. You know, the beavers were solid through here, and that's incredible to think as you look out on this dry Gila bed that is huge. I mean, it's just so massive. It's just incredible. And Gila Bend needs to be a monument. So whatever needs to be done, that needs to happen. So whatever we can do as a channel to make the monument happen and to move it forward, because here's the reality. If enough of the groups on Facebook get together, these Facebook exploring groups get together and bond and have one common goal, which is to make this a monument, I think we can get it done. It's just an incredible place. You know, me and John are just walking down talking about the journey. And what'd you think, John? What'd you think of the journey today?
Oh, I thought it was awesome, man. Tough one to find, but well worth it.
Here, I can't believe how cool it was to see this area and to know that this is just one spot of hundreds of areas out here that that the ancients lived. So Jay Schreck, Black Flag Expeditions, man, I'm glad you could come along today. We're not done today. We're going to keep going, but I'll see you later. And remember, we have a live show on Tuesday, so make sure that you watch us on Tuesday at 7 o'clock, and that's on YouTube. Jay Schreck, Black Flag, adios amigos.